गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, साई राम। आई अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल टू द ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स। चिल्ड्रन, टुडे आई अगेन गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सेम चैप्टर, दैट इज़ चैप्टर नंबर 6, एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज़ बैंकिंग। एंड दिस इज़ द सेकेंड वीडियो ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, एंड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव फिनिश अप द फर्स्ट कंसेप्ट ऑफ बैंकिंग, दैट वॉज कॉमर्शियल बैंकिंग। सो वी हैव फिनिश अप फर्स्ट द कॉमर्शियल बैंकिंग, Thereafter, all the functions of the commercial bank and the most important credit creation by the commercial bank. That was the most important topics of the commercial banks. Now, today we are going to start our next topic, that is the central bank, I mean the meaning and functions of the central bank. This is the second important topic of this chapter, and thereafter we will learn the controller of money supply by the central bank, that is RBI in our country. So children, now first is, what is central bank? Now what is central bank? Central bank is an apex bank, or you can say a central bank is an apex institution that controls, operates, regulates and directs the entire banking and monetary structure of a country. It is known as an apex bank because as it occupies the topmost position in the monetary and the banking structure of a country, as all the financially developed countries have their own central bank. India's central bank is the Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI, and RBI was established in April 1st, 1935, under the Reserve Bank of India's Act 1934. So, a central bank is so called because it occupies a central or the topmost, or you can say the highest position in the monetary and a banking structure of a country. And in India, the Reserve Bank of India is the central bank of a country. So, what is RBI, children? RBI commenced its operations on 1st April 1935 during the British rule in accordance with the provision of the Reserve Bank of India's Act 1934. Reserve Bank of India was set up based on the recommendations of the Hilton Young Commission of 1926. Therefore, the RBI was nationalized on 1st January 1949. So children, these all are the broad explanation of the establishment as well as the preamble of the Reserve Bank of India. So children, the Reserve Bank of India, as I just said, was established on April 1st, 1935 in accordance with the provision of the Reserve Bank of India's Act 1934. The central office of the Reserve Bank was initially established in Calcutta but was permanently moved to Mumbai in 1937. The central office is where the governor sits and where policies are formulated. Though originally privately owned, since nationalization in 1949, the Reserve Bank of India is fully owned by the Government of India. So now let's learn the preamble. The preamble of this Reserve Bank of India describes some basic functions of the Reserve Bank as to regulate the issue of banknotes and keeping of reserves with a view to secure the monetary stability in India, and generally to operate the currency and credit system of the country to its advantages, to have a modern monetary policy framework to meet the challenges of an increasing complex economy, and to maintain price stability while keeping in mind the objective of growth. So these are obviously the main objectives of the Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI. So now children, let us learn the functions of RBI. As a central bank of the country, द आर बी आई ऑफ इंडिया परफॉर्म्स वेरियस फंक्शंस. नाउ फर्स्ट फंक्शन इज नॉट इशूइंग अथॉरिटी. सेकेंड इज बैंकर्स टू द गवर्नमेंट, दैट इज सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट गवर्नमेंट. बैंकर्स बैंक एंड सुपरवाइजर, दैट इज द थर्ड फंक्शंस ऑफ द सेंट्रल बैंक. नाउ फोर्थ इज कंट्रोलर ऑफ क्रेडिट, कस्टोडियन ऑफ फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रिजर्व. दिस आर द फाइव फंक्शंस ऑफ द RBI. And we do have one more functions, which is the some functions of the bankers bank and supervision, and it is also the most important, lenders of the last resort. Now Chinna, let us move to our first function of RBI. So children, first function of RBI is note issuing authority or bank of issue. So children, central bank has the sole authority for issuing currency in a country. In India, Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI, has the sole right of issuing paper currency notes except 1 rupee note and coins, which are issued by the Ministry of Finance. So under the Section 22 of the Reserve Bank of India's Act, the bank has the sole right to issue bank notes of all the denominations other than 1 rupee note or coins, and all coins issued by the government of India. So children, all the paper currency notes what we have in a country except 1 rupee note is printed by the Reserve Bank of India, and this 1 rupee note as well as the coins are printed or issued by the Ministry of Finance. Now second is issuing note in denomination of rupees like 2, 5, 10, 20, 50, 100, 500 and 1000. Now 1000 is not in existence, known as bank notes, and carry a guarantee by the central government. RBI can issue notes against the security of gold coins, gold bullions, foreign securities, rupee coins, government of India securities and bill of exchange, some of the promissory notes. So out of this, the value of gold coins and foreign securities should not be less than 200 crores. Now when RBI is going to print the currencies, now the RBI has to keep a reserve in the form of gold coins and foreign securities worth rupees 200 crores, in which 100 crores is in which the gold coins, the gold should be equal to the value of 115 crores, and rest will be the foreign securities. Or you can. So children, as I just said, all the currencies based or you can say all the currencies issued by the central bank is its monetary liability. That is, central bank is obliged to back the currency with assets of equal value, and to emphasize or to enhance the public confidence in paper currency. So that was the first the functions which is performed by the central bank of a country. And for us in India, that is being performed by the Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI. Now Chinna, let us move to the next function, that is acting as bankers to the government. So children, the Reserve Bank of India acts as a banker, as an agent and a financial advisors to the central government and all the state governments of our country. As a bankers, it carries out it carries out all banking business of the government. First, it maintains the current account for keeping their cash balances. Now, on behalf of children, all the state government as well as the central government, RBI is authorized to maintain a current account for keeping their cash balances. Second, it accepts receipts and make payments for the government, and carries out exchanges, remittances and other banking operations I mean, on behalf of the all the state governments and the union territories as well as the central government, all the receipts and payments are done by the current account of the RBI. And RBI is authorized to receive the payments on the government's behalf and make the certain payments. Third, it also gives loan and advances to the government for temporary periods. I mean, the Reserve Bank of India also gives loan and advances to the government for the temporary periods. The government borrows money by selling treasury bills to the central bank. Now as an agent, the central bank, that is RBI, also has the responsibility of managing the public debt. You all must be knowing, as we are as the commercial banks is having their accounts with the RBI, similarly as an agent, the RBI has the responsibility of maintaining the public debt. Third is, as a financial advisor, the central bank advises the government from time to time on economic, financial and monetary matters. These are the functions which is being performed by the RBI, acting as a bankers to the government. So children, as I just said, RBI acts as a government banker, agent and advisor to the central and state governments. RBI has the obligations to transact government business via to keep the cash balances as deposits free of interest, accepting checks, receiving and collecting payments, transferring funds to receive and to make payments on behalf of the government, and to carry out their exchange, remittances and other banking operations. These are some of the most important functions which has been performed by the RBI, acting as a bankers to the government. So now children, let's move to a next functions of the RBI. Bankers, agent and advisor to the government. So as I just explained you, this is the explanation of previous functions what I have just explained you. The Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI, acts as a banker's agent and advisors to the government. So it helps the government with short term loan and advances in terms of difficulty. The RBI is lending money to the central government and the various state governments at the time of the difficulty, and Government of India borrows money from RBI to finance its budgetary deficit. If there is any deficit with any state governments, any central government, or even with the union territories also, then the Government of India borrows money from the RBI to finance its budgetary deficit. And the third is, as a government agent, the central bank conducts sale and purchase of the government securities and also manage national debt and foreign debt. These are the functions which has been performed by the. So that was your function of a banker's agent and advisor to the government. Now children, let us move to the next kind of functions of RBI. Now third function is bankers, bank and supervision. So children, there are a number of commercial banks in the country. There should be some agency to regulate and supervise their proper functioning. So therefore, being an apex bank, the Central Bank of India acts as a bankers to the other banks. For this, it bears the same relationship with the commercial banks as they later maintains with the general public. So as a bankers to the government, as a bankers to the function, the Central Bank of India performs their functions in three main capacities. Now first is custodian of the cash reserve. So, children, the RBI holds as a part of the cash reserves of India, as we have already learned in the commercial bankings also, that all the commercial banks it is a legally compulsory for all the commercial banks to keep a certain proportion of their deposits as a cash reserve with RBI. The same we have learned in the last concept of money creation by the commercial banks. And then second is the RBI lends their funds for short periods and provide them with centralized cleaning and cheap and quick remittance facilities. It provides the following functions like payment and settlement of interbanking obligations and fund transfers between the two banks, deposit insurance service to the banks, cash reserve ratio, that is CRR, and acting as a lender of the last resort functions. So, children, the first function which is performed by the central bank, that is RBI in India, the first is the custodian of the cash reserves of commercial banks. So, as I just said, children, commercial banks are required to keep a certain proportion of their deposits as cash reserve with the central bank. In this way, the central banks acts as a custodian of the cash reserves of the commercial bank. Now next is children, lender of the last resort. So, children, when commercial banks are failed to meet their financial requirement from all the other sources, and all the commercial bank approaches the central bank to give them loan and advances as the lender of the last resort. So, central bank assist these banks through discounting of approved securities and bill of exchange. So, children, this lender of the last resort function, you can understand when this commercial banks are failed to earn the fee from the public, then the central bank in India, that is RBI, is the last option available to get the money from the central bank. So that is why it is called that lender of the last resort function. So by giving accommodations in the form of pre-discounted collateral advances to the commercial bank, bill brokers and their financial institutions, the central bank act as a lender of the last resort. So the central bank lends to some institutions, the commercial banks, in order to help them when they are faced with such a difficult situation, so as to save the financial structure of the country from collapse. So this was the function. And the third functions in bankers bank and supervision is clearing house functions. So, children, as central bank holds the cash reserve of all the commercial banks, it becomes easy and more convenient for it to act as a clearing house. Central bank holds the cash reserve of all the commercial banks, so it becomes very easier for it to act as a clearing house. So all commercial banks, as you know, all commercial banks have their accounts with the central bank. Therefore, the central bank can easily settle their claims of various commercial banks against each other by making debit and credit entry in their accounts. So I'm going to explain you here, children, as all the commercial banks has their banks with the central bank. So if there is any dispute arises in between of any two any commercial banks, then RBI itself can settle their claims by making a debit and credit entry by their own side. So that is why it is one of the most important functions of the RBI. So the central banks acts as a clearing house for other banks, and the mutual obligations are settled through their clearing system. So since it holds the cash reserves of all the commercial banks, so it is very easier for the central bank to act as a clearing house. So children, now as a supervisor, what the RBI actually performs? So as a supervisor, the central bank regulates and controls all the commercial banks. So the regulation, I mean the you can say the regulation of all the banks may be related to their licensing, branch expansion, credit allowance, liquidity of assets, management of their funds, merging or winding up, etc. These all are the functions which is being performed by the RBI as a supervisor. So the control is exercised by periodic inspection of banks and the returns filed by them. So children, if there is any bank, any commercial banks, if they want to expand their branch, if they want to wind up, or if they want to merge, or if they want to increase their ATM services, or for any liquidity of assets or any kind of management, this control is generally exercised by the central bank by the periodic inspections of the bank and the written file by all the commercial banks. So now let us move on to the next topic. The next kind of function is controller of money supply and credit. So children, the RBI of India, the Reserve Bank of India, that is RBI, is empowered to regulate the money supply in the economy through its monetary policy. So it is the monetary policy is what? It is a policy which is adopted by the central bank of an economy in the you can say in the direction of the credit control or money supply. As RBI has the sole monopoly of issuing currency, it can also control the credit and supply of money. So even RBI is issuing the currency, but it also performs the functions of controlling credit and supply of an economy or money. For this, the RBI may use the following instruments of the monetary policy. So children, as I just said, central bank can control the inflation and deflation situations in the economy through various control measures, and credit control measures are also an instrument of the monetary policy. So there are two most important methods of credit control or as a money supply in an economy. So RBI controls the money supply and credit by adopting the two instruments. The first is the quantitative credit control, and the second is the qualitative credit control. So that was all the explanation of the bankers, bank and supervision which is performed by the RBI. So children, so far we have studied first the definition of the central bank. We have also learned that all financial developed countries have their own central bank in their country. Bank of England is the central bank of UK, and Federal Reserve Bank is the central bank of USA. Same way, Reserve Bank of India is the central bank of our country, and it was established on 1st April 1935 under the Reserve Bank of India's Act 1934. Thereafter, we have learned the functions of the Reserve Bank of India. We have learned first function, that is currency authority, I mean bank of issue. Thereafter, we have learned bankers to the government, and the third function we have also finished with bankers, bank and supervision. So in bankers, bank and supervision, we have learned the three broad categories of this function, like first is custodian of cash reserve, thereafter is lenders of the last resort, and thereafter is clearing house. as a supervisor also we have learned what are the key responsibilities of the RBI to control and to control and to directs the entire banking system of a country. So children, that's all for today. Have a nice day, and in the next video we will learn the next functions of the RBI, and we will also learn all the different situations like the inflation and deflation in a country, and how the RBI takes the monetary policy to control the money supply in an economy. So that's all for today. Have a nice day. Thank you so much, and Sairam.